हरि ओम। पतंजलि स्टार्ट्स एक्सप्लेनिंग द थ्योरी ऑफ क्लेश और वी कैन से फिलोसॉफी ऑफ क्लेश एंड ऑल दैट बिकॉज ही हैज गिवन फाइव मेन कॉजेस फॉर द क्लेशस। बट इन द सूत्र नंबर फोर पतंजलि सेज अविद्या क्षेत्रम उत्तरेशम प्रसुप्त तनु विच्छिन्नोदारणम। फर्स्ट इज अविद्या, ignorance, that was the first klesh as he has explained, and then asmita, raga, dvesha, abhinivesha. So he said the first is avidya, and avidya is a cause for remaining four, and all remaining four kleshas they originate from avidya. That is the meaning of avidya kshetram uttaresham. Uttaresham means after that, all remaining four, this Uttaresha. And Kshetram is the cause. So avidya is a basic cause. And from avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, abhinivesha, these are generating. And they are all are creating the klesh, disturbing the whole life. That is why he says avidya, kshetram, uttaresha. And then he explains, these kleshas, they develop slowly, slowly, slowly. They develop in four levels: prasupta, tanu, uchinna, and vidharanam. To understand this, I want to explain one very simple and interesting example. We sow a seed in the soil and start giving water or some manures or some medicine, but nothing comes out. The seed is there, but under the ground, nothing is out, so you can't see anything. So this is prasupta stage. That means the klesh is there, but you can't see the effect. No effect, no result. You cannot notice it also, because it is underground. So this is the first stage of klesh, that is prasupta. Then tanu. After a few days, you find out a small plant comes up above the ground, and you can notice it. And it looks very nice and attractive also. So I'm very much happy for that. So this is the second stage of kleshas. First is prasupta, where you cannot notice it also. But now it is, you can notice it. And it looks very nice also. Very interesting also. Just like a small plant. Definitely it is interesting. So it's in this level of kleshas, people are attracted towards that. They say it's very nice, very good. Actually, it is a klesh disturbing the life. But we get attracted because of its small size. So this is tanu. Stage is tanu stage. And next stage is vichinna. Now that plant is turned to a big tree. So many branches are there, so many leaves are there. It's very big tree, it becomes very big. So like that the klesh also, first it was prasupta, underground, then tanu, little bit above, it's very attractive, then becomes converted into big tree. So it covers lot of area in our life. And then we start feeling the distress and discomfort and pain and misery and all of these things at this stage. At tanu stage we are attracted to that, but this stage we are disturbed with that. And final stage is udharanam. That means the fruits are coming out, there are the seeds in the fruits, they can again sow in the ground, and again the number of trees will come. So these kleshas are disturbing the life in like this. Initially it is prasupta, we can't notice it. It is there, but we can't notice it. Then it becomes tanu, it becomes attractive. But when it becomes vichinna, then we are disturbed with that. And in udharanam means total disturbance, it destroys the whole life. That is how interestingly he has mentioned the four stages of these kleshas. And he says, all these kleshas, avidya is a root cause. So he is more focusing on avidya. And when avidya is destroyed, all other kleshas also will be destroyed and everything will be destroyed. That is the aim of yoga also. That is how he is explaining yogic techniques hereafter. Hari Om.